Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold Jerry, retired lecturer in metallurgy, scientist, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. You don't need to believe me, because such things you have to find it yourself. It's not written in the books. It is get written over your heart, and all the things are in your heart. Gospel is from your heart and not from the book. That's why St. Paul said, his word or logo cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart, because logo is the end product of logical reasoning. So if you are capable of logical reasoning, then you will hit logo, end product, nectar. And that is his word. And that settles on your heart. Then as you have studied it, you have done it, all the research, you can preach gospel from your own heart with authority. Not that as these people do it, you know, this man said, that man said, it's written in this Bible, that Bible. That is super donkeys carrying holy books. Let the dead bury their dead. They are spiritually dead people, men of dead letters, that get degrees in university, PhD, doctorate, but they have no knowledge of theology or the gospel. If you ask them, in whose name John baptized the Jewish men in water, and he never baptized a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan, they can't tell you. I can tell you. So here I wanted to tell you, you know, these Egyptians, we have found that they preserve their dead people as mummies, and they are still coming out, you know, and the blood is still fresh. Blood is the life or the essence of the people. That's why Jesus said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus means what came out of the mouth of Jesus. You have to hear it with this ear. This is the ear to eat the spiritual knowledge. So eat the flesh of Jesus, what came out of the mouth of Jesus. Hear, take it to your heart, and then digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning to brew logo. And logo is his word. Then you preach gospel from your own heart in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our supernatural Father. That is called drinking the blood of Christ. So, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me or in life, or life in me. Or you have life in Satan if you don't do it. As you are seeing now, people fighting with each other and all that. Nobody bothers to understand what came out of the mouth of Jesus. So, here you are. Now we have a lucky, you know, in the world that we have a demonstration nation in the world, which is the chosen people. Abram was brought from Iraq area, the cradle of humanity. Yahweh picked him up and brought him in the Middle East. He left all his family, everything there, even his surname, he did not have it. So he came in this Middle East as Adam, and Sarah was Eve, and promised land given was the Garden of Eden. So they were living, Adam and Eve, living in the company of Yahweh, enjoying the best fruit in the Garden of Eden, the promised land. So far they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. But as soon as they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, then the same land became barren. That is what happened when Jacob had 12 sons. When the crook, 11 crook, they sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptian because he was not of their type. He was an honest person, and he would tell the truth to Jacob. whereas the other, they were telling lies. So as soon as Joseph left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Abraham or to Yahweh. So our Yahweh is a jealous and revengeful. When you are not faithful to him, you are faithful to Satan. So he then turned the land into a desert or barren, nothing to eat, because Yahweh, why should he feed the sons of Satan? He only feeds the sons of man, which has created, Yahweh created Adam, and we are the generation of Adam. Yahweh, we call him Brahma, and in Arabic called Khuda. Kudrat Khudaidi, Noor Allah. That means the Kudrat, nature belongs to Khuda, Yahweh, Brahma, and the Noor, light inside us, religious light, is from our supernatural Father, Allah, Elohim, and Parbrahm. So, this chosen people, they were set as a demonstration nation in the world, and we should appreciate their sacrifices. When the blind guides let the blind, they fall into the pits of Holocaust. So Christ Jesus came to give them light, and his own they loved darkness, and they killed him on the cross because of the light. So that's why they suffered. Now, Abraham had two sons. The elder one was Ishmael, and the younger one Isaac. And that story of prodigal son is, father is Abraham, elder son is Ishmael, and the younger one is Isaac. That's why Isaac, give me my share, I want to leave. And that was when they threw out Joseph from the promised land. And they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. And they have to leave the country. And they went to Egypt, where Moses brought them back. The same land became lush green. So, the elder one is Ishmael. Now, Ishmael was faithful son of Abraham, as in the prodigal son. He said, you know, when the fattened calf was killed and all that enjoyment, he told father, hey, I was faithful to you for the whole life. I never had such a feast or enjoyment as this man who was a prodigal, unfaithful to you, had come back to you. That is the treatment the Ishmael people had. That means they were feeding, they were getting the food, everything, but not as good as the chosen people when they were faithful to Abraham. So the morality or the faithfulness to the father, which is to Abraham, all goes to the Ishmael people. Whereas the spirituality, because that Isaac was born of the well-wishes of the sadhus, boom of the sadhus. So spirituality go to these chosen people. So when Isaac was born, then Abraham took Ishmael and Hagar and put them outside the boundary of the promised land, because the land goes to the real son, Isaac, and not to the one born of the slave girl. So the slave girl's people, Ishmael people, they remained faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. Whereas the chosen people, they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, when they became Jew outwardly. So when they became Jew outwardly, here you are. So here is the Adam. Under Adam you have races, under races you have tribes. And there is no mention of Jew here. So that's why this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam. And that's why the 144,000 they are mentioned in the Revelation, those who will be saved, are all mentioned by their tribes and not as Jews. So that's why here tribe, you know, only. And here is the spiritual self. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Spiritual self, Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, they are way of life. They are not born, they are not never die. This is born and this is die. Flesh. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust because Jew is a spiritual self. Now this fact is hardly known to any. And there was one man who told me, he gave me the answer, that was in Germany, and he was a porter in a hotel. And I went to a kitchen talk, and he told me, when I asked how many Jews died during the Holocaust, he said, zero, none. I said, how the hell you know this answer? Then he told me, Jew is a spiritual self. That was correct answer. So such things are known to very rare people. I asked him to join hands with me so we can preach gospel, but he was not happy. He said he works in a hotel. If the hotel people come to know that what I'm preaching, they will throw me out. So he was frightened to preach gospel, not to carry the cross. So that is why when Jesus was a baby, when he was born and they wanted to kill him, the Jewish people, then Joseph was told to take him to Egypt, the land of the Ishmael. And he took him there and they honored him very highly. They honored him very highly. They looked after him. Mary was not short of any food or anything. And they were comfortable in Egypt. But when he grew up, because he had to do the ministry in the promised land, because they were the spiritually sick people. So he was the spiritual doctor. So he returned back to Israel, promised land. And over there, they did not treat him well. They maltreated him. So he formed his ministry and preached the gospel. And that gospel was not well received by the Jewish people as far by the foreigners, outsiders. So even today, people of Israel, they don't appreciate gospel delivered by Christ Jesus. As we people from outside, I'm from India, Punjab, where the second coming of Jesus took place. Because I know the second coming, Christ Nanak or Satguru Nanak, then I know Christ Jesus very well. So that's why I can preach gospel from my heart. There's no need for me to read book and go by the dead letters. No, the chosen people are so arrogant and greedy that Elisha, he cured one Syrian general, Nama was his name. And when he was cured by taking bath in the river Jordan, and then he wanted to present a gift to him, then he came to give him gift, you know, as the required by the rabbi or other thing to present a gift. So when he came to present the gift, Elisha refused to take it because he got the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, from our supernatural Father free. When he received that free, why he should take money from other people? So he refused to accept any gift from him. And there was a greedy man when he was going back. And he said, made excuses that my guest come from this country and that. And he then, that general gave him the gift, you know, because he needed them. So greed had been dominated among them, and they were arrogant because they were chosen people, elite. And that went overhead. That means they became Jew of physical self, not of spiritual. And those people in Israel, those who realize that when you become Jew outwardly, you break your covenant with Abraham. Because Abraham was not a Jew. If he was a Jew outwardly, then the Ishmael people would have been Jew outwardly as well. But he was of Semitic race, a Semite. So they become unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh, and which is called tares. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. The farmer is Yahweh, and wheat plant are sons of man, and salt of the earth, and the tares are sons of Satan, saltless people, as the temple priests were, who crucified Jesus. For what? For doing good work to them. That is how the Satan will react to you. If you do good work, then he get harsh on you. So what I mean to say now is that in Abraham, the elder son Ishmael had the morality of Adam. And when Jesus went in that Egypt, in one of the town he went, the chief priest was worshipping Adam, the statue of Adam. He made a statue of Adam and he worshipping him. And when Jesus entered that village, that statue broke. That now the real Adam is Adam, second Adam is has come inside. You don't need to worship this stone Adam. So he was not upset, and his son was not mentally sound, and Jesus stayed in a hospital. So when Mary washed his clothing and put it on the line to dry up, then his son, who was not mentally sound, he took some of his linen and put it over his head. And he was cured of his sickness. And he went to his father in good state. Father was surprised. Hey, what happened to you? You're cured. So then son told that I took that thing. Then that priest honored Jesus, and they looked after him well. And people used to get the water in which he was being bathed to cure their physical sickness. And all that thing was happening. So this is Adam. The Adam things all went to the Ishmael people. Spirituality went to Isaac people. Spirituality made them arrogant. They had the temple over there, and he had Hajarite here. Hajarite to become son of man. And here they had temple. Both, you know, of temple of Elohim, which had a curtain around it, holiest of holy, which was destroyed in 70 AD. They tried to rebuild it two times. A fire came and made them to run away. That temple is now in India, in Amritsar, called Golden Temple. Same size as the holiest of holy used to be. And Jesus tore the curtain off. That was his mission. When he breathed his last, the curtain of the holiest of holy torn from top to bottom. That means you have now direct approach to God. You don't need any intermediary. So these people, doctor, priest and other thing, you see them in churches, they are antichrist created by the messianic Jews who used to kill the apostle or the light giver because they loved darkness. So today even, so for the, in Adam, Adam is a physical self. They honor their forefathers, or they were the salt of the earth. And in honor to honor them, you know, they mummified their bodies. They preserved it. And they made big, big tombs and other things, which you won't find in the whole world. Similar thing, maybe to some extent similar. In some country I've seen that the people, when they die, the people don't bury that dead person straight away. They will be carrying him out and in their house. And I don't know how they preserve it, you know, because it starts smelling. But somehow they make him to come out and sit. And all that they do, after a certain time, maybe they bury it, you know. So the best preservation of the elders was among the Egyptian. Even today, the mummies they have found, the blood is still fresh. That is not because of the medical or other things, because of this Adam, worship of Adam. They are special nation, special one, Egyptian. They worship Adam. The chosen people worship God, Elohim, Allah, Abram, both. Because they are both temple of Yahweh, the potter, where they were selling cattle and money changers, and Jesus turned their table. That was his heavenly father, Yahweh. That's why his name is Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shiva means primal Adam. So Jesus was the second Adam, firstborn of Yahweh, and Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph foster father. So he came floating, and floating he left. He left no mark on earth, because second Adam had not a hole to rest his head. Remember Jesus said, foxes have hole to rest their head, but the Son of Man has none, because he was second Adam. So now I hope so that it become clear these people were humble, faithful to salt of the earth. Recently, President Morsi, he wanted to form his Muslim Brotherhood. When you become Muslim Brotherhood and you become fanatic, then you become sons of Satan. And the Egyptian people put him in jail. Even he was elected, properly elected president, they put him in jail for that fanaticism. And here I tell you what it means when he becomes the Muslim Brotherhood. In Kaaba, which is the temple of Adam, there are three pillars. They are Satan. Seven stones are thrown at each. And this is called Al-Jamar Al-Dunya. These are the bastard born of the prostitutes and the temple priests. And these are the mustard seed, lowest one. Jesus was anointed mustard seed. And this is the middle one, where people change their tribal identity. If people from India came to Arabian country, to mix with them, they put on the surname like Ansari, Jafri, and this and that, Arabicized their surname. But they kept the family tree in secret. When they were married or anything social, then they would consult each other's family tree. So they were real sons of Satan. This could be a saint. But this is a real son of Satan, he can't be. From here he get promotion. When he exploit people, the politics is in Adam. In Adam you have races and tribes. So politics is a tribal affair, not of this communist, labor, conservative and all those parties, green party, this and that. But when you become make green party or conservative or these people, you vote for them, that means you are supporting them. Then you are supporting Satan called Al-Kubra. This is a Satan kneeling against a hillock. Hillock is the mountain of fanatics, bastards, super bastards. So they fight on this basis. But when the people become Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, they take on religious color in politics. Because politics is a tribal affair. The land belongs to tribe and not to Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. To Hindu belong the temple, Sikh belong the Sikh temple, Muslim belong the mosque. So that's their property, but not outside. Outside is the tribal properties. So when they become tribal people outside, outwardly as Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, Jew, outwardly, then they became unfaithful to their tribal fathers. And this Satan is called Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, which is of the highest power, very powerful Satan, where he exploits people under sectarian rules. He creates the sectarian rules. So you get a very heavy destruction. So President Morsi is this Satan, kneeling against this hillock of Muslim Brotherhood. And look what the Egyptian did. They put him in, elected president, they put him in jail, and in jail he died. So this is the proof how much they love their tribal people or their physical identity they want to keep in touch. So they remain faithful to, even today, to their tribal father. Some fanatics, of course, do the wrong thing, you know, bombing the church and this and that. But at their heart, they are very faithful to Abraham. So this is what I want to say, that in Ishmael, you had Adam. And that's why Jesus, when he was baby, he was sent to his care. I remember how Herod killed 2-year-old boys. As the Jewish people have told him that he is born, he is the king of the Jews, king. And their position, Jewish position, was in danger because he set us free of these dog hollow priests or the yokes. So they were frightened of their positions, as when Lazarus, he was a proof of the fruit of gospel truth. Gospel truth set you free. And when he was rose on fourth day, which is the resurrection, he was the first fruit of resurrection. Then the temple priests were very much upset that if we let Jesus do what he is doing, then all our customer will go to Jesus and we will have no income, no money coming in. And that's why they killed Jesus, jealous of him. And so, You can see, you know, that the prophet came among the Jewish people and they maltreated them. Some they beat, some the other thing, as Jesus told when he was made last journey to Jerusalem. Then he said, our Father sent the very Son, Christ Jesus, and look, they are going to kill him too, a Lamb of God, which they did. They beat him mercilessly, as expected of the saltless people, sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. And they beat him hardly, so much so that Peter, who loved him so much, he was too frightened to tell people that he is one of the friend of Jesus. And later on he wept, you know, when he realized what Jesus told him, and it has happened. Peter was once born of the 12, but clean-hearted like Nicodemus. And so in this one, that's why he got the key to the kingdom of heaven, which is a law and order and truth. And he killed Ananias and Sapphira, two liars, blasphemers. Much more I can tell, and I will leave it here. So now you know that why in Egypt there are mummies and no mummies in Israel or in the promised land, because this Isaac is stand for spirituality and Ishmael for morality. Our Father God blesses everyone alike in love called agape. I hope I have covered everything, and maybe you are interested in the royal kingdom of God where Jesus took us up. Here is the John the Baptist below, witness to the light and not the light. Witness to the light and not the light. There you are. This is the moon. John the Baptist was moon, and Christ Jesus is the sun, the primary source of light. Here are we saint, and here we have prophet. Prophet. So John the Baptist was the last prophet. Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets foretell John the Baptist, none after him. So the promised land, the chosen people, produced all the prophets. But as the people were arrogant or greedy, people like Elisha, prophet Elisha, there were so many lepers in Israel, none of them was cured. A Syrian leper, general, who came to him for cure, because he was not greedy, he was clean-hearted. So Elisha was happy to cure him. And the one, when he was leaving with the gift, you know, back to Syria, one of the chosen people went after him and made some excuses that my guests are this and that, you know. Give me those gifts, you know. And he took gifts from him by hook or by crook. Greedy people. So then Jesus, in the synagogue, they wanted to throw him out because he told them the gospel truth, that you people are greedy and good for nothing. And same in the temple, when Jesus told them the nature of the super bastards. Remember in John 8, a woman was brought to him for judgment. She was caught in adultery. And these people, Stanic, you know, over there, the people of Judah tribe, they hated him the most because they were the sons of Satan. And they brought a woman caught in adultery and asked Jesus to give the verdict. Now the verdict of the morality is given by a moral priest and not by the spiritual preacher, Christ. So, like John the Baptist, he was the rightful person to give the moral decision, and not Christ Jesus, who had nothing to do with moral law. Because law and prophets were till John the Baptist. Afterwards, the gate to the royal kingdom of God has been opened by Christ Jesus, which has a narrow gate. And this is the royal kingdom of God. Here, when you enter this one, you have to turn your seed into plant. You bury the ego or the seed and turn it into plant. Here we are one father and we are all his sons. Soul is concerned here, not physical flesh. So, in spiritual sense, we are all brethren here. And Christ Jesus is our anointed elder brother. So this is where Jesus' royal kingdom is. And the people were working and as laborer, you know. So, if you enter this one, there's a kiln of fire, you know, burning bush. So you have to bake your faith. You have to bake your faith in this kiln. And this kiln is oral Torah, or His word. And then you become perfect sons of Most High, Allah, Abram, Elohim, which is Christ, and not Christian. And then you preach gospel among your people, and then he finished his job, you know, on this earth. The subject is very easy, it's all here. Once you get the gist of the subject, then everything comes from here. So if you just think logically, then you get it. As I thought about this mummies, why in the world Egypt has mummies and nobody else has mummies? Because of this demonstration nation of Abram or Abraham. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape love. This is agape. This is Eros, which was the love created by Moses in the wilderness. And that lifted this rift between the brethren, called lifting the snake. Not the snake that wriggled on the ground, but spiritual snake, the rift between brethren. And here is the agape. Agape is the divine love, unconditional divine love, because in God, our soul is concerned, we are all brethren. So none is higher, none is below. So this is the one, you know, which is agape, unconditional divine love. And here is then philia love, philosophical love. So when you ponder over His word, two or three sitting together, then they are all philosophers and they love each other, and that love is called philia. At Pentecost, when they got the very Spirit of God as their reward for working hard, they get the Holy Spirit with capital S, and the love is called storge love, storge, family love. Oh, much more I can tell. So our Father God blesses everyone alike, because in God we hate none, because the light of God is in each one, whether he is holy or evil.